It was the easiest attempt I had made at doing it, and I got the best result. And that's kind of where this started. And I got the idea for that, what I'm gonna show you, from a 1940s prosthodontic textbook. And then I just put it together with some other stuff I was doing, and that's where the reverse preparation technique came from. It's still how I prep teeth to this day. Now, basically, we've got all the depth cuts where they need to be, and it's just time to blend all of these. And so even if it seemed like we took a little extra time, you know, on the front end of things, putting these depth cuts in, this is where you're really free to fly because it's just kind of a race against time here. Just grab that 856025 and start reducing. It's a lot like having Waze or a GPS unit on your phone. You know when you're done now based on the depth cuts. You know, before I would just be prepping and prepping and prepping and wondering if I'm done. Yeah, I think I'm done. My hands get a little tired. I think I'm getting closer to getting done. Now I know exactly when I'm done, when I've reached my destination. I wish the handpiece would say,
"You've reached your destination."
When you finish the prep and all the depth cuts are gone, but it really does feel kind of like a guided technique in that sense. Here's the 856016 burr. That's the little brother of that other one. See, we can hold that vertically and take it in between that tooth and the PFM next to it we don't want to hit. We can take that on the mesial aspect of tooth number 9, and we can create that same kind of vertical wall down to the level of the gingiva without hitting that natural tooth, tooth number 8, next to it. And if we took that other burr, the 856025, in there right now, we'd have to tip it so far over that we would end up with one of those TP preps. And that's how those teeth tend to get over-prepped in the incisal third, is by taking too large of a burr and taking it in between, taking it in proximal too quickly. So we use that little one first, and then we finish up anything we need to do with the 856025, blending those depth cuts. Step 7 is the lingual reduction. I'll usually mark this with a piece of articulating tape, and wherever that lower anterior tooth is hitting, if I'm doing zirconia, I'll put a 1/6 of a millimeter depth cut right through that blue mark.